In September, some of the biggest names in music will come together for an online concert to combat poverty. One of those bands is Evermore, and they are our music guests tonight.
We're famous for it, taking talented New Zealanders and calling them our own. Evermore is no exception. Adored Australia-wide, three times platinum and a greatest hits album later, this set them up to be nominated for seven arias. Having already toured with the likes of Pink, Maroon 5 and Matchbox 20, they're now taking their music live online for a charity concert in September, playing alongside Stevie Wonder, Kings of Leon, Alicia Keys and John Mayer. Let's follow the sun and seal the shadows fade. After the huge success of last year's hit Follow the Sun, the band will be hoping to get an even bigger following with this hit One Love.
Well, we're all up on the desk now, Hermione and Adam and John and Peter of Evermore. Welcome to the late news.
Yeah, good to be here.
Yeah.
The Global Citizen Festival.
That's the one.
How does it work? What's involved?
Well, there's a massive concert in Central Park in New York with Stevie Wonder, Kings of Leon.
Alicia Keys.
And who else? We're missing somebody. That's all.
And Evermore.
Yeah. John Mayer. How can we forget John Mayer? Come on, he's a pretty big name. Sorry, John, if you're watching. And that's being live streamed to Melbourne, and we're actually playing at the concert as well, and another Australian act to be announced.
Yes. How did you guys get involved in this? The ties actually date back quite a few years, don't they?
Yeah, we did the Make Poverty History concert in Melbourne, quite a few years ago with Hugh Evans, who started this, and then we had Bono and Pearl Jam, and since then we've just loved working with him. He does amazing stuff. We really believe in this Global Citizen Festival.
Such a great cause.
Yeah.
Now, your background, the stables, that's your home studio. Can you tell us about that?
Yeah, well, it's actually an old stable that we converted to a recording studio. So it took us a few years, but it's finished now, and lots of albums being made there, our records and albums for Lisa Mitchell and some other amazing Australian bands. So, yeah, it's great to be able to make our music there and write with other people, and it's just a fun environment away from the city a little bit. It's like a 10-acre farm as well. So,
can you clear it up for us? Are you proud Kiwis or Aussies? Can you?
I wish it was that simple. It's just not. So I was born in Australia, then grew up in New Zealand, and now I live here for like 8 years. So. It's tough. And then he was born in New Zealand.
Yeah.
So even though we're brothers, we're sort of like...
I feel a little more Kiwi, I reckon.
He feels more like a Kiwi. I feel like an Aussie, but I've got more of a Kiwi accent. So is that really helping you?
You've got that identifying feature that you just can't shake, because people are like, no, you're Kiwi, you sound like a Kiwi.
We're somewhere stuck in the middle of Tasman, you know?
Yeah.
And like, it's really weird. I'll go for Australia in the Olympics, but if it's like rugby, I'll go for the All Blacks. So.
Oh, well then you are Kiwi.
I'm Kiwi and I have to go for the All Blacks.
I think it's just tough going for New Zealand in the Olympics though, because, you know, they don't usually win anything.
What about keeping it in the family? I mean, is there a particular sort of chemistry there because you're so close?
I think definitely, you know, we grew up writing songs together, making music together, and if it works, if it ain't broke, don't fix it.
Sure. We've really not done anything else or really done a band with anybody else. So
never
it's
had a real
experience.
Job, so.
Yeah.
There are no boundaries.
Yeah.
It's kind of easier with family in that way, is it?
Yeah, I think so. I mean,
it's so normal to us.
We don't know anything else really, but no, it's really fun, and you know, we enjoy it, and you know, people are loving the new song as well. So, I don't know if we said before, but the new song's actually released. One Love's actually released to raise awareness about the concert and the Global Poverty Project. So all the sales are going towards it. So it's really cool.
Great. Well, we can't wait to hear it, and we'll hear it a little later on. Thanks so much for being here.
Yeah, definitely. Thanks for having us.